Good morning, I'm Eric Scott. This is New Jersey's First News for Tuesday, July 12th. You're going to feel the heat and humidity when you step outside. Even early this morning, our chief meteorologist Dan Zero says it is going to be a swelteringly warm and humid day today, and that could trigger some stormy weather later, particularly in parts of North Jersey. Not everywhere, but powerful thunderstorms are a possibility this afternoon and into this evening. Dan has all the details for you on air, online at nj1015.com, and on our free mobile app. A 17-year-old Bergen County high school student is dead following a horrific crash. The student's two-door BMW sedan hit a utility pole. This was on Marginal Road about 3 o'clock Friday afternoon. No other vehicles were involved. All four students in the car were 17 years old and male. The three injured victims are still hospitalized. Superintendent Jack Hurley says a candlelight vigil will be held at Lincoln Park tonight. We have expanded coverage of this story at nj1015.com. A woman is in a lot of trouble after police say she fought with officers at Hurricane Harbor because she didn't want to leave. Jackson Police and the Ocean County Sheriff's Department claim Cameron Serrano of Union County and another woman were refusing to leave as the water park was closing July 3rd. Serrano from Elizabeth accused of repeatedly kicking two officers and spitting at one of them. She faces three counts of aggravated assault on a police officer, among other charges. Gas prices have dropped again overnight, down another 2 cents a gallon. Here are the latest numbers from AAA this morning. Prices have now fallen 35 cents a gallon for regular in the last month. It was a month ago we first hit the record of $5.05 a gallon. AAA put the average price this morning at $4.69. That is down another 2 cents. Gas prices have been steadily falling now for more than a couple of weeks. A year ago, though, we were paying $3.16 a gallon. The cheapest county averages this morning, Sussex at $4.62 a gallon. Most expensive remains Somerset at $4.89. When President Biden's Build Back Better bill was defeated in the Senate last year, also with it came the prospect for a big tax deduction for New Jersey. Now New Jersey U.S. Senator Bob Menendez is trying to resurrect a measure to raise the limit on how much state and local property taxes you could deduct on your federal return. The $10,000 Trump-era SALT cap has hit New Jerseyans hard. Since we pay the highest property taxes in the nation, Menendez is trying to include changes to the SALT cap in a bill aimed at reducing prescription drug costs. Air travel in a post-pandemic world has been extremely frustrating. Well documented, all the schedules that have changed with delays and cancellations. But now Biden administration officials are targeting fees that are being charged for families to essentially sit together. They are urging airlines to drop the fees that are charged for an adult or a parent to sit with a child under the age of 13. This is among the many changes the DOT is proposing on a federal level to try and make air travel more pleasant in the U.S. A popular party boat based out of Sea Isle City apparently hit the Townsend's Inlet Bridge last night and partially sank. There are pictures on social media of the starfish. 22 passengers were safely evacuated. No injuries are being reported. NJ.com reports the starfish boats have been offering charter fishing and party cruises since the 1950s. A man and a woman are being sought for at least two casino robberies in Atlantic City. On June 15th, according to state police, the male suspect seen here forcefully took about $15,000 in cash from a patron at resorts. Then on July 8th, same guy back at it, stealing $12,000 from someone at Caesars before fleeing. It was the woman in these photos who was driving the getaway car, according to police. Both victims had been seated playing slot machines. Anybody with any information is being urged to contact the State Police Casino Operations Unit. If you have comments about our top stories, leave them right here. Please like and share the video. And remember, we are always taking your calls, talking Jersey on air on New Jersey 101.5. I'm Eric Scott. That's New Jersey's First News for this Tuesday, July 12th. Have a great day.